Okay, now what I'm going to do is create an action for the start, and I'm gonna just keep the center as UI button and I'm gonna connect it. Next, I'm gonna say timer, sorry, not this timer, the variable timer dot schedule. No, oh, sorry, timer equals to the other timer dot scheduled timer with interval. Yep, this one. I'll just keep this to view controller. I'm gonna give the interval as 1, target as self, selector I'm gonna give hashtag. Press the hashtag selector. I'm just gonna give that, and I'm gonna say view controller dot action. I'm just gonna give action and user info. We don't have anything, so nil. Repeats is true because we want the stopwatch to keep going on. Next, I'm gonna give the start button dot is enabled. Equals to false. Okay, now I'm just gonna go back to the split view so that we can do our next function. Oh right, so we forgot to add one function to this. Say objective at objective C func action, just like we gave to the view controller, and 0 parenthesis, nothing in it. And here we're gonna say seconds plus equals 1. If seconds equals to 0, sorry, 2 equals to 0. 60, I mean, minutes plus equals 1. We want to add 1 to the minutes. Next, what we want to do is say second equals to 0. So it starts again with seconds. Then we're going to say minute label dot text equals to minutes. And we're going to give it in a string because this is a variable, this is an integer. So minutes. Then again, seconds label dot text equals to seconds. Seconds. There we go. Then we're gonna put another if statement. If minutes equals to 60, then hours plus equals 1, then minutes equals 0, then we're gonna type seconds equals 0 so that it starts all over again. And seconds, wrong here. Okay, that's the second guy. I'll just see what's wrong. Oh wait, maybe it's our label. Yeah, there we go. So it's this, then minutes slave var CPU, just for calculation purposes only, equals to 0. If CPU equals to 0, second label dot text equals to seconds. There we go. I'm just gonna delete that after copying it. When I say delete, it's gonna give hours equals to 23. When it's that, we want to invalidate this timer so that it stops, you know, functioning. Next. No, I'm not gonna have this. It's just a little bit waste of time. And let's not have this variable as well. What's this? Stop. Yeah, there we go. I'm gonna say hours label dot text equals hours. Hours time, then minutes label dot text equals minutes, minutes, then seconds label dot text equals to seconds. Now this is cleared. Seconds. So now this is cleared. Let's take a split view and go ahead to the next function. Let's do the pause function now. Action type Y button is going in this pause. Connect it. Here I'm just gonna say timer dot invalidate. Then I'm gonna give start button dot is enabled equals to true. So now the button will get enabled. Next, let's do the reset function. Let's make an action. Something's wrong. Okay, so we will continue in the next.